What I want out of each and every one of you is a hard target search of every gas station, residence, warehouse, farmhouse, hen house, outhouse, or doghouse.
I just want to watch this movie over again, the full thing now. A doctor wrongfully accused of murdering his wife escapes from the law in an attempt to find her real killer and clear his name. The Fugitive starred Harrison Ford, Tommy Lee Jones. It was shot right here in Chicago. Filmmaker Andrew Davis brings his classic 1993 thriller to the Music Box Theater tonight for their 90th anniversary celebration. It's a pleasure to welcome back one of Chicago's very own. We grew up blocks away from each other. Can you tell? Like, we're brothers, but we really did grow up in the same neighborhood, not far away from each other.
Really?
It's great to see you again.
Good to be back.
What do you think of when you see some of these scenes? I think this is one of those movies that when you're surfing around on television, you see it, you stop whatever you're doing and watch the whole thing.
I hear this a lot. You know, I've had people call me up and say, you know, it was 3 a.m. and I was in London and it was on and I stayed up and I didn't have any rest all day.
Right.
So I'm very flattered.
Yeah. But does it bring back certain memories for you in the making of this film when you see clips of the movie?
Sure. Any movie you make brings that back. But The Fugitive was a great experience because of, you know, the proximity of being in Chicago and having a great crew and working with this incredible cast. And it was a film that was sort of made on the fly. You know, there was a lot of improvisation. A lot of things changed as we went along. For example, the St. Patrick's Day Parade, which is in there, was never in the script.
Classic scene. An actual St. Patrick's Day Parade. It's not
right.
Something that you staged.
My first film, Stony Island, I wanted to put it in. And Richard Daley, Richard the First
died. Richard the First, yes.
And
King
so
Richard
the
First.
So his funeral is in there. So then yeah. we had this big chase through City Hall, and we didn't want to do a French Connection chase again, you know. Yeah. So we said, well, what about if we have them run through the St. Patrick's Day Parade? And we got permission from the plumbers to join their crowd, and we had a couple cameras running around, and yeah. It became real.
I think the St. Patrick's Day scene is iconic in the movie, and so is that waterfall scene. Absolutely amazing. And to this day, when I watch this, I think, how did he shoot that? So tell me, how did you shoot that?
Okay, so we built a set on a dam. The only thing shot not in Chicago was in North Carolina.
Yeah.
And we built a dam, set on this dam, and recreated it in a studio. So we're going back and forth from location to studio work. And actually, we threw a dummy over the bridge.
Oh.
And our editor, Dennis Verker, kept saying, you're never going to make this work. He called it Stick Man.
Yeah.
And somehow, they were able to make this dummy move around. And,
right.
And then we shot in the swimming pool and got in the water in North Carolina.
It's amazing. It's amazing to watch all of that. And The Fugitive really kind of set the tone for other filmmakers, making Chicago sort of the place to come and shoot your films after that, don't you think?
Right. I think that Hollywood woke up that a Chicago crew and a lot of Chicago actors could make a film that's successful. And it turns out Harrison's from Chicago. I'm from Chicago.
Right.
And, you know, there was a lot of background to this. We had made Above the Law, Code of Silence, The Package. I think it was my fourth film that I was going to make in Chicago.
Did I hear correctly that Alec Baldwin almost was Dr. Richard Kimball in this movie?
Not when I was involved.
Oh, not when you were involved.
No,
okay.
I know there were a couple other parts that he was up against against each other. But this came right after Under Siege, and Harrison had seen the film and decided I would be okay to direct The Fugitive.
Yeah. What do you think of movie making today? I think The Fugitive is, you know, a classic, and in many ways the kind of movie we don't see made anymore. What's your take as a very accomplished director of what's on the scene right now?
There are several articles on the 25th anniversary about how they don't make films like this anymore, which I think is too bad.
And a nice compliment for you
but
also.
But you know, I think it's called eye candy. You know, the visual effects, the train crash feels real because it was real.
Yeah.
And now people go to movies and they see these incredible action sequences and everybody knows this, nobody's really in jeopardy.
Fake, it's all digital. Yeah.
It's all digital. And I think that the things have to travel around the world. So there has to be a story that generally is humorless because it has to appeal to what's funny in every part of the world. And it's, you know, you're seeing sequel upon sequel. And I think that television is starting to replace the kind of content that The Fugitive offered.
Yeah. Two guys from the Southeast Side just sitting around talking about one of the greatest movies ever. I went to CVS, you went to?
Bowen.
Good old Bowen High School on the southeast side.
Went to Gene Krupa.
That's right. And mine was home of Dick Butkus and Chris Zorich and Bernie Mac and so many others. So we've got a good history on the south side, good track record. Thank you for coming back. Thank you for all the great movies.
It's great to be here. There'll be a lot of cast and crew there tonight, so I'll be looking forward to seeing everybody.
You'll be able to see Andrew at the Music Box, their 90th anniversary celebration tonight with The Fugitive at 7 o'clock. By the way, tomorrow, a Dolly Parton marathon, Sunday, they have sing-along Mary Poppins there. It's a big month for the Music Box. You can get more info at musicboxtheater.com.